What's up, everyone? AJ here again with another episode of Replicating Dribbble Designs in SwiftUI. So I want to apologize first and foremost for not uploading any videos in a couple months here. My startup club is, getting a lot of traction. It's getting harder and harder to find some more time to do stuff like this. But I really do love replicating these types of designs on Dribbble. And someone actually reached out to me and to replicate a design they found. So that's the main reason why I'm doing this. And honestly, if you guys have any more designs you want me to replicate, feel free to send over. For now, we are going to replicate this left design here. And if anyone wants to see this design created, more than happy to do that as well. And then, honestly, my next episode, I might just add some animation here, to be honest. But let's start with this, okay? So, first and foremost, I'm going to keep everything in one file. Usually don't want to do this. Usually want to split things up into components and then integrate it into one page. But for time purposes, I won't be doing that. So, let's go ahead and embed this into a VStack. And let's go with the image. Let's actually bring up SF symbols. We're gonna need that. Arrow left. We got a long arrow that we could use. Perfect. Arrow backward. Okay. So let's come in here. Let's do an image. System name. Arrow left, was it? Did I forget already? Oh, arrow backward. Backward. Okay. And then we're gonna come in here. Let's go ahead and add a V stack like this. Add another image, system name, and let's call this. I wonder if they even menu. Hamburger? No. Lines. Line. Okay, line 3. Let's just copy name. And let's put you right there. And then what we're going to do, we're going to come in here and space this out. Spacer, okay. So I just want to get a little closer. This, yeah, that's fine. Okay, and then what we're gonna do is actually come in here and do a font dot system size, and let's make this 24. Let's come back in here and do the same thing. I'm just gonna copy this, and then for the V stack, I'm gonna do a frame width of 34. Height of 34. Okay. Corner radius of, I'm going to say 12. And we might have to just up this a little. And let's come in here and do a dot background modifier. Color literal. Let's grab the picker. Other. And let's go to this. I don't know why that's not working. And we're gonna go make this color. I wonder if they have a 2. They do not. So we're gonna have to use this 3. You could make a custom one if you wanted to. I'm kind of thinking about it. You know what? Let me see if I can do this real quick. Let's do 10. Do a dot frame of width 24 and height of 4. 6. Okay, and let's do a foreground color literal. Let's come in here, let's grab this guy, do the same thing, and it's gonna be this yellow. Okay, and then we got that, and what we're gonna do is we're just gonna copy these, and we're gonna add spacing 0, let's make it 2. And might have to bring this down just a smidge. Make this like 4. There we go. Okay, so this button is gonna be actually we can just do .clip_shape_circle. Perfect. And it seems like let's do something like that. And then what we're going to do is come in here, we're going to do a padding of that horizontal, let's make it 25. Okay, so I'm going to calm this down just a little here, and yeah, that looks better. Okay, so we got that down. Next thing, we're gonna actually embed you into a VStack, and let's go ahead and extract the subview, get this out of the way, call this a header. Okay, let's resume. Next, I'm going to create a VStack. Let's create a VStack, and with that VStack, we're gonna add an image. It's gonna be called Tesla. And we're going to do a resizable dot frame width of 200, height of 140, 160 seems about right. And then I'm gonna actually embed this into another VStack, come in here, add an image, and we're gonna do system name again. And let's go and do a pin, or can I do location? So it looks like we'll use this pin. And you know what? Map? All right, we'll do mapping. It's not ideal, but it'll get close. All right, so let's come in here and do mapping. And we're gonna change this to a Z. And we're gonna do a font.system size of 40. Gotta be bigger, actually, 150. 140 and 120, 100. Okay, and we're gonna do a dot offset of y minus 100, minus 80, 50. So, let's see if we can do a rotation effect. That 90 180. Damn. Okay, no worries. All right, we're gonna get as close as we can, because obviously Apple has some restrictions, unfortunately. And what we're gonna do here is we're gonna do a H stack below here, and that's gonna have text of save park 2 with another text of $5 an hour. Okay. And this is going to be a font title. Bold. Yeah, I like that better. And then it's going to be dot font dot. Let's do. What's this look like? No, it's got to be bigger. Headline. Let's actually do large title. There we go. And this doesn't. Let's do dot. Title 3. Yeah. Okay. And let's go ahead and this actually seems bigger. Yeah. And then let's do something like that. All right. You know, I'm actually not going to have, I don't like this thing in the back. I don't know why they added that. Let's just do that. And let's come in here and then let's add a spacer. Space these eyes out. Oh. Okay. And then what I'm gonna do is come in the H stack and give a padding dot leading of 40, 50, 60. Then a padding dot trailing of 20. Might have to be 30. Yeah, line up with this guy. All right. So our top half is done here. Let's definitely fold this. Okay. And then what we're gonna do is build the second part down here. So we're gonna add another V stack, and we're gonna do a text of end time. And then what we're gonna do is come in here, add an H stack. This is gonna be a tech. This is gonna be we're gonna make this. I wonder button. Make this text. Make this say today. Foreground color is gonna be black. It's gonna be a font. It's gonna be dot heading. And then let's come in here and add a frame width of 180, height of 34. Whoops. This actually looks way too big, so make this 140. And let's add 38 to that. And then come in here, let's add a background color, color literal. Come in here like this. Let's grab this, grab this. Grab the picker. Let's get that out the way here. Do a corner rate. I always like doing clip shape. Rounded rectangle. Corner radius is 20. Okay, just kidding. 20. All right. So then this might actually be like a 120. Yeah. So then what we're going to do is actually just copy this stuff. And we're going to make this guy say tomorrow. Okay. And then come in here and do it one more time. Can it fit? Okay, so we're probably gonna have to make these smaller, which is not an issue. And it says later. And what we can do is we can remove this. No. Make this white. Make this white. And let's make this 100. And make you 100. Or 80. Okay, and then let's see here. Alignment. Okay, so I'm going to embed you into an H stack, and then I'm going to add a spacer, and let's do a padding dot leading of 50. All right. And then what we're going to do, so, okay, so we got all that. So let's fold this H stack here. And no, we don't want to fold that H. Yeah, we do. Fold this. And then what we're going to do is we're going to add an H stack here. Call this text 1041, 1040 p.m. And this is going to be font.largeTitle dot bold. Okay. And we're going to come in here and we want to add a spacer to this. Then do a padding of that leading and make sure this is 50. So let's actually head on to our safe park and make this 50. Okay. Because this today kind of pops out a little. And then we're going to come in here. And let's definitely fold you. And where are we at here? This is going to be large title. This is the H stack. Come down here. And let's add another H stack. And let's do circle. And dot, let's add a dot frame. Width of 8. Height of 8. And border width, color dot black, and yeah, that's fine. And then let's do a foreground color of dot white. This is black. This is color literal. Let's grab this. Grab this guy. Alright. Okay, let's make this 12 by 12. This 2. Okay, so we got that guy and a text that says alert me 15 minutes before. Okay. And then what we're going to do is just add another spacer, come back, padding dot leading is going to be 50. Let's make it 54. Lines up better. And then last but not least, we got to add our button here. So let's go ahead and add this into a H stack. And then what I'm gonna do here is I'm not gonna add it. I'm gonna do an image system name. And it's coming to here, it's to arrow got anything here that we can use? Chevron. And let's do a Chevron. Oh, here we go. Chevron right two. Copy name. That, oh. This, and then we're gonna do a font that's system size. I'm gonna make this 28. I'm gonna come in here, and I'm just gonna add this into a VStack so that we can add a frame modifier of width of 46. Height of 46, clip shape, and it's going to be a circle. Dot clip, circle, and then do a background modifier, color literal. And we're gonna wanna grab, actually I can just copy this, put this here, put this there. All right, and it looks like this is like a 24 maybe, or even a 22. And then what we're gonna do after that is, I'm gonna come in here, and we're gonna add a text of slide to park. Okay, and then after that, we're gonna add a spacer. We're gonna then come in here, add a padding of that leading of 55. Okay, this H stack is gonna be dot padding of that horizontal of 50. And actually let's get rid of this real quick. 50. Okay, then we're gonna do a dot frame. No, we're not. We're gonna do a dot background color. Color literal. Grab this other. Let's grab this little picker here. Just get this gray. Okay. And then we're gonna do a dot foreground color for you. Color. Color literal. Then we gotta come in here. Let's grab. Oh, let's get rid of you. Other. Come in here and get this slide to park here. Okay. And I'm just gonna make this a dot bold. Okay, so we after that we're gonna want a corner radius of 20. Oh, this is okay. So this is my issue here. This is what I was saying. Okay. I think I have to put it before. Yeah. 14. Nah, it's definitely 20. And it's at a frame of height of 50. Okay, and then what we need to do here is just add padding leading of like 4. 8. Yeah, it's about right. And then we'll add a spacer here, but we'll do a frame of width 40. Yeah, cool. And so let's make this 54. Make this 27. All right, so we have everything in place here. Now we gotta do some spacing. So first I kind of want to get this this V stack first. So let's come in here and fold this and add some modifiers here. And let's grab this. Okay. And then we're gonna do a frame height dot infinity. There we go. Max height dot infinity, and then we're gonna do actually grab this, and you know what I'm gonna do actually? Do a frame max height dot infinity, grab this background color, edges ignore dot all. Okay, so we have that. Now what I want to do is come in here. So end time, we're going to fold. Actually, we're going to keep this V stack folded. And what I want to do now is add some padding of top of 50. And then this header actually needs to be right in here. Okay, and then this V stack has to have a dot background color literal. And we're gonna grab this yellow, and it seems like this bottom stuff here is going to be a padding dot bottom of 20. Okay, getting close. And then let's go ahead, is this done? This is done. There's that little from the image, that's okay. And let's fold this, and this is gonna, we're gonna extract this sub view and call this top view so we can see what we're doing here. End time's gonna be a foreground color literal. Let's grab this color. Yeah, I like that end time better. So let's add a spacer. No, I don't like that. Padding. Actually, you know what we could do? We could do a spacer with a frame height of 25. Is that about right? Yeah, it's about right. And then what we're gonna do is come in here, and we're gonna do the same thing. This is okay. So that okay. Yeah. So we need to actually make this here, and then one last one, and we're gonna make this blend in like this, and then it seems like this stuff is white and this is white. Cool. And last but not least, this alert seems to be foreground color dot white, and the circle is a square. And I'm assuming that's because this might have to go here. You know what? We're just gonna make this color literal. Okay, and then this H deck here, I kind of want to do a. Yeah, because this actually. This actually expands like that. Okay. And then last but not least, make this actual foreground. That white, and I'm actually just gonna give this a custom size, honestly. Font system. And we're gonna make this 48. Make this that bold. Oh my god. That bold. Alright, and then what we're gonna do here is I'm gonna come in here, add a spacer dot frame height of 20. And then it seems like there's an even bigger spacer right here, frame height of 34. And then last, let's add a spacer to the alert time. And let's make this 20. It might be 30, honestly. All right, so I kind of want to make this like a 64. Yeah, and let's increase the size here to 54, to 54. Yeah, I like that better. And then last but not, so also guys, like with a lot of code, like this is what I was saying. So a lot of the times when you fold here, so you can click a bracket and you click fold to like see, you know, obviously see your code, and then you can always like open it up. And what I always like doing to like, obviously, honestly, I like spacing things out. So when I'm done, you'll actually see me. Like what I was gonna say is like, when you're trying to find the end of like this H stack, just click this parentheses and it highlights. You see that? See how it highlights? So now what you can do is you can come in here and you can do little things like, I'm about to show you. Okay. So what's that is spacing here. So what I can do is, I think it's, I wonder, yeah, you can honestly just comment, end time text. So you kind of remember, right? You want to, it's going to be buttons. So like space this out here like this. And let's call this guy time. Space this guy out. And then right here, let's call, what's this, alert. And then last but not least, and we're gonna call this slider. Okay, space this out like this. And now you have like, you know, it's not the greatest, but what would you really wanna do is you'd wanna break this slider button out into a whole new component. You'd have a component folder, and then you'd call the slider component here like this. And you know, it would, you know, you'd say something like slider like that, whatever you call it in the file. But like I said, for purposes, you know, time purposes, I didn't. So I'm just gonna call this bottom view. So now we're done, guys. I mean, this is very close to what, you know, I think this looks cleaner in my opinion, without that background mess, that the background symbol. And I'm thinking about, you know, creating a new video of showing, you know, maybe some animation with this slider, maybe some transition going back to the main view here. But yeah, Mini Cooper has this type of capability. But yeah, so I'm gonna shout out to my guy here and let him know I replicated his design. And yeah, I hope you guys really enjoyed it. I'm trying to do more of these. Please send me some. Just, you know, comment a link that you want me to replicate on Dribbble. And I'll be happy to do it in SwiftUI. So I hope you really enjoyed this episode. And I will definitely see you in the next one.